Hi, it's Jane from Craft with Jane.co.uk, and today I'm bringing you my Lily Pond Lane fold flat gift box. It's a lovely sized gift box, and if I open it up, you can see that it can be folded flat, so it's quite clever. So you can make a load of these up, keep them nice and flat, and then when you come to you need them, you can bring them up. But I just love this gift box. I think it's gorgeous. I've made it with a Velcro close. You can make it with magnets. You don't even need the close. You can just use ribbon to tie it close or make a little sleeve to go over it. But I just think it's lovely. And I love this designer series paper. It's from the annual catalogue and it's Lily Pond Lane. So it's 6x6 designer series paper and it's got these cute little ducks and fish on it. And it's got obviously lovely lilies and water scenes. And as I said, it's called Lily Pond Lane. And for the sentiment, I've used the Throughout the Year stamp set and I've got the Happiest of Birthdays. And I've used my favourite Nested Essential dies for the sentiment strip as well. So you use a full sheet of cardstock for this. This actually measures 8 inches by 11 1/4, so it's suitable for A4 and American letter as well. So on the long side, the 11 1/4, I'm going to score it at 1 1/4, 4 3/4, 6 1/4, and 9 3/4. And then I'm going to rotate it and I'm going to score it at 1 1/2. And then you can do 6 1/2 or you can rotate it and do 1 1/2 again. I'm going to burnish all of my sides. The colours that I have used for this is the Pretty in Pink, which goes with the designer series paper. And I used and for the other box, I used the Pretty Peak. Two of my favourite colours. I think they go really nicely together as well. So, and it seems the designer series paper does as well. So you can see that this is slightly smaller and this is going to be my flap. So what I need to do is cut off the two pieces either side here. So I'll get my snip out. And there's not actually that much cutting to do for this project. I'm going to cut down just like this to that second score line. And then I'm going to cut down here, like that. I'm gonna do exactly the same here. So cut down here, and then cut this away. Actually cut it this way, I find it a bit easier to cut it this way. Just like this. Okay, so that is all of the cutting that I need to do. However, I do need to trim this little piece off, so I'm just left with this and do exactly the same on this one, like so. So it measures 1 1/2 by 3 1/2, and I need to score them at the 1, and again both of them. And these are just going to make the lovely side flaps that hold the contents into the box, and they just look really nice. And then I'm going to burnish them like so, and then I'll cut off the corners of the edges just like this. And these will come in just a second to, so that's all of that cut off. And then I'm going to use a corner rounder and I'm just going to round the corners. Oops, sorry. Just like that. And then do the same here. And then do the same here. On this box, because that's going to be the flap, I'm going to corner around these edges as well. Just like that. There you go. Now, I do need to do a tiny bit more scoring, but I'm going to need a ruler for this. So I'm going to go from the inner point just here to the outer point of all of my four corners. I'm just going to press that down. So I'll just show you, just like that. I'm going to do that on all four corners. And this is what makes the ability to fold flat. Like this. Very good. That's done. Bone folder out again. Fold these areas over like this. And then just bring this in like that and burnish inside. So I'll do the same on the other corner. So I'm going to keep this piece down, bend that up like that, and then just burnish. And then I'm going to do exactly the same here, just burnish. And do exactly the same just here and burnish. There we go. Right, so I will then glue my side pieces down. So I'm going to glue these outside triangle pieces because they need to stay relatively flat, just like this. I'm going to do that with all four of these corners. So it's the outside triangle that I'm doing on all four pieces, like so. And then I'm going to press that in like this. And just hold it down for a second. Like this. And then I'm gonna open the box up and just make sure it all fits as I'd expect, and it does. Lovely. So next, I'm gonna do something very similar. I'm gonna be gluing this just on the inside here, so I need to pop some glue. You can use your tear and tape for this as well if you want to, but I am choosing to use liquid glue. I find it a bit easier to line it up and it gives me wiggle space. So I'm just going to make sure this lines up nice and straight, which it does, and then I'll just make sure that that is pressed in like so. I'm going to do exactly the same on this side, and then I'm going to start gluing on my beautiful decorative layers. So once I've glued both of these into place, and this is really economical because obviously you've used the pieces off the side that you've cut away from here, so it's really clever, nice use of them. There we go. And then just pop those down like so, and then I'm going to use my bone folder to make sure all of these edges are in. Lovely. So these are my layers. I have one piece. I love this paper as well. It's so pretty, isn't it? It's got the pretty peacock with the pink. So this is 4¾ by 3¾. This is 4¾ by 1. There's two of these, and they are 4¾ by 1¼. And then you've got two of these, which are 3¼ by 1¼. So I'm going to glue these into place on the box. I'll start with this one because it's the easiest to place. And I've corner rounded this one as well, just for you to be aware in advance. So I'll just pop a little bit of glue on the back of here, and I'm going to press this into place like so, trying to give it a relatively equal border, and press it down. This is sort of directional, but obviously it's easier to do a project like this with a non-directional paper, because you do need to be thinking about which way around you need things to go when the box is made. And then this piece goes in just like this. And I'm going to press that one down. Just love this colourway. So that one's there. And then thinking about the box being made up like that, I need to make sure this piece goes on the right way. So this one's going to go on like that. So I'm going to glue the back of it and pop it on like so. Nice. And then the same on this one just here. And then, so that's all of those there. And then I'm going to turn it over and do my two side panels just here. So just pop some glue on here like this. Press that down and the same on this side. You can put a piece in here. And if I was going to gift this without a card, I might actually put a white piece in here, measuring 4¾ by 3¼, maybe do some stamping on it, and then I could write on it, you know, to and from, because it would be on the inside of the box, and I always think that's pretty. And some people as well might choose to put a piece of designer series paper in there, which is absolutely fine to decorate it. I love the idea of doing that. Okay, so that is the box completed, and I'll just fold it up to show you that that is how it looks. So I'm going to put my Velcro dots on now. So I'm just going to hold it like this. I got these Velcro dots from Amazon ages ago. I would say years ago. I'm going to put two dots, one here and one here. And then I'm just going to press this down quite firmly. And they're the ones with the little hooks. And then you've got the bits here, which are more like fluffy, which hold it in place. And I'm going to stick these upside down on the hooks, like so. And then when I come to close the lid, they should stick roughly where I need them to be able to catch the box shut. So I'm going to make sure I line this up as best as I can for this motion. So I'll take it to the edge, and then I'm just going to press it down like so. Press those two bits down. And then gently open them, trying to keep the Velcro separate, like that. And you can see I've got the two softer, fluffy bits there, and then the two other bits here. And that is the closure completed then. So if I bring this up and close it, it's a lovely box, isn't it? And then press this down. That is the completed box just there. So for decorating, I'm going to use the gorgeous coordinated bordered ribbon in the Pretty in Pink, and just open up my lid for a second, and I'm just going to do a lovely little bow, I think, because I do like a bow if I can get one across. So the bottom part, maybe the bottom third of the box lid, I'll put this little bow off at a lovely angle. Like that, and then I'm going to do a little bit of paper snipping, ribbon snipping, just like that. So that is my cute little bow off to the side. I will shut my box again, like so. Oh, I really like that, it's really pretty, isn't it? And then I have already pre-done my Happiest of Birthdays in my Pretty in Peacock ink. So I'm just going to use some Stampin' Dimensionals on the back of here. So I've got a couple left on this sheet, and then I'm going to start a new sheet. Just one there, one there, one there, and then I'm going to take one off here for there, and just take the backing off. Like this. Oops, I'm going to come off. There we go. And then I will stick this about here. Yeah, quite like that there. Happiest of Birthdays. That's nice. And then with this Lily Pond Lane suite, you've got these adhesive backed dappled dots. They're so cute. And I'm going to pop some of the pink ones on this one, I think. I used orange on the last because there is orange in there as well. And it's my Take Your Pick tool. And I'll pop them, put them down. No, on the map, I think. One there, one big one, and then one little one, just like that. These are my completed Lily Pond Lane fold flat gift boxes, and I think they're lovely. I hope you've enjoyed the project as well. Let me know if you've got a preference to which colour you prefer. I do love them both, so I'm finding it hard to pick today. Love the idea of making absolutely loads of these up and having them ready to go. They're a great size as well. You can fit like sweets, chocolates in them, jewellery, makeup, like a self-care kit with some moisturiser, lip balm, hair bubble, you know, cute little sort of survival kits. You can put all sorts in them. They're big enough and they're a really good size, and they use that one sheet of either A4 or American letter, which is with a cardstock, which is really handy. If you're interested in purchasing any of the products that I've used today, or you would like to buy any Stamping Up products, you don't already have a demonstrator and you live within any of the countries in Europe that Stamping Up sells in, please do consider shopping with me. I'd be honoured to earn your custom. I do send out lovely thank you packs each month to my customers with qualifying orders. And also, if you'd like to join my team, I'll put links below. I've got a lovely little team, so we'd be honoured to have you. I'm really delighted. Okay, I'm going to say bye for now, guys, and happy crafting.